Liber 31, The Diary of a Chod, Part 2. September 25th, 1918. Last night, before sleeping, I discovered, or rather remembered, for I had noticed the fact in December last, that all is the silent sound of the indrawn breath through the nose with the mouth closed, and law that of the outgoing breath. This is a further proof of the nature of the holy word, which is before the spoken word. Note the similarity with that of neophyte. Also, it means this, that one cannot help repeating the most sacred name of God whenever one is silent, so that every man and woman has been doing this from birth. September 26, 1918. I have been making further considerations of this holy mystery of the silent breath, and it is very wonderful to think how whenever one breathes silently, one is pronouncing that true and ineffable name. Every living creature is then, by reason of their nature, worshipping the true God, whatever their opinion may be. Also, note that neither wisdom nor understanding is essential to this. It is, and as long as we live, we must perform this operation at least during sleep. And it is written, He giveth himself unto his beloved in sleep. September 30th, 1918. I have today finished a design for a symbol to express as well as I can the results of my initiation of December 21st, 1917, as explained in my further enlightenment of September 22nd, 1918. It is intended to represent Kether with the supernal triad radiating therefrom. This forms AL and LA, also AA and IAO and OIV. Also, the center of the circle is Hadit and the circle Nuit. The circle can be taken to represent La, etc. The angle is 120 degrees, or one-third of a circle. The shape, bounded at top by circle, and below Our Lady Nuit for her pentacle, etc. Have ordered it to be made in white gold on 1-inch base. Monday to Tuesday, October 7th and 8th. Have been working on the theory that the Holy Word revealed to OIV-VIO in its inmost aspect is also the key of the mysteries of the Book of the Law. Let us consider in what ways this may be so. My experience showed me that Hadit was Kether, and Nuit appears to be very similar to the veil of the negative which the Kabbalists speak of. 777 seems to confirm this, for Hadit is attributed to line 1 and Nuit to 0. Also, same idea is symbolized in that which was granted to me when I made the pentacle of Nuit. I think the idea we should try to formulate is very much that of the Kabbalists, though the real meaning is, I am convinced, a matter of experience. First was nothing, and this may be called law. While it is considered as expanding into limitless space, Ein Sof, and becoming limitless light perhaps, the beginning of things was caused by a simple change of conception, as it were, a looking inwards instead of outwards, and a corresponding change from law, lamed aleph, to all, aleph lamed. I think the difference in the way the English and Hebrew alphabets are written is a good symbol of this. The direction is different, so that the two letters might stand for either, LA or AL, according to the manner in which we look upon them. The great value of this word lies in the fact that the selfsame symbol contains the ideas of nothing and something, without any change in itself, and this seems to be the one symbol that gets over the difficult transition from not to one. Of course, it was not even a word in the beginning, but the silent breath, expansion, and contraction, and the true theory of the universe is that it was created by the first breath of the Tao, or Nuit. We find this confirmed in Liber Legis, chapter 1, verse 28. None breathed the light, faint and fairy of the stars, and two. Here we have the idea of the first breath of Not, La, or Lamed Aleph, the limitless light, which concentrates upon Kether, which is one, or Hadit, or all, Aleph Lamed, and gives the first faint idea of duality which shows forth in the word later, but which being composed of the ideas nothing and one is really one. Now Hadit is really unextended, and can only be imagined as the minute point of light at the point where La, or Lamed Aleph, changes into all, or Aleph Lamed, for he is the secret center. In order to get a somewhat clearer idea, we must consider Nuit as dual, viz., Lamed, Aleph Lamed, Aleph, when Aleph Lamed, or AL, shows up as that center. In this case, it is strange and worth noting that we have a word with the sound Layla, or night, and I don't think the spelling matters, for see chapter 3, spelling is defunct. It is the sound that matters. I cannot help thinking Allah was in the same way produced and was concealed in Allah. We are told in chapter 1, verse 9, to worship the Kaabs, the house of Hadith, and behold my, Nuit's, light shed over you, because Kaabs is the central point of light, and we thus perform an act similar to that which made creation manifest rather than not. Chapter 1, verse 21, with the God and the Adorer I am nothing, they do not see me, they are upon the earth. I am heaven, and there is no other God than me and my Lord Hadith. Now if Hadith equals all, or Aleph Lamed, God, then with him is Nuit, law, nothing. Also, this is so with the adorer, unless he concentrates on Hadith as the center as instructed. Yet is also true that there is no other God than me and my Lord Hadith, for looked at one way, the God is Nuit and the other Hadith. Chapter 1, verse 22, clearly tells us that Nuit has a secret name. This I take to be La, or possibly Layla. Also, it is written in this verse, bind nothing, and besides its obvious sense, this may be an expression of the binding of nothing by concentration on a point. This word binds nothing, as it causes the transition from nothing to God. Chapter 1, verse 29 and 30, it will be seen that there really is no division. Chapter 1, verse 35, note threefold Book of Law, October 31st, Law is Law, L.A., Nuit Hadith, completed by W or Vav, the sun Rahur Kuit, in his dual aspect as Horus Harpocrates. Also Vav or Bau is the Arafant, Hor in his secret name and splendor is the Lord initiating. Chapter 1, verse 40, note three grades. Since making this note, I have had an opportunity of looking at the equinox for a moment and discovered that in Volume 7, comment, the Tarotis of the three grades add to 31, which I consider a further proof. I may remark that I have been placed where I have no books but the VSL for reference, and am therefore writing all these notes entirely from memory of my experience, which seems to make certain things clearer from day to day, as I apply my attention to different aspects of the work. Chapter 1, verse 45, the perfect and the perfect are one perfect and not two, nay, or none. Here I think Nuit and Hadith are referred to as the perfect, for this is claimed by Hadith, see chapter 2, verse 15. If Nuit be considered as La or Lamed Aleph, and Hadith as Al or Aleph Lamed, this is at once clear, for they are one and yet none. Chapter 1, verse 46. Nothing is a secret key of this law. 61 the Jews call it. I call it 880-418. I made a partial explanation of this in diary, but since, I got a clearer and fuller one on October 21st. I insert same here in its proper place. Today, I have made another attempt at the Kabbalistic explanation of the verse. It is getting clearer. At the time of initiation, it will be remembered, OIV-VIO identifies himself entirely with Parzival throughout. 2. October 31st, 1918. Just before sleeping, I had an impression that if I added up the total letters in my mottos, they would equal 31. I did so mentally and found Unus in Omnibus is 13 letters, a chad, Omnia in Uno is 10 letters and reduces to 1, Parzival is 8 letters, 13 plus 10 plus 8 equals 31. This is extraordinary because it was a kind of revelation. For he says he found the word, and the word was Parzival. There is, of course, a very definite connection between Parzival and Abrahadabra, the word of the Aeon, through 418. It is also said that Abrahadabra shall be his child, and that strangely. And Parzival, having 8 letters, an initial value 80, and total enumeration of 418, is therefore connected with this verse. It was through this name that he came upon the mystery of Aleph Lamed and Lamed Aleph, which is finally summed up in Aleph, as will be shown later. Let us take this verse again. Nothing, L.A. or Lamed Aleph, is a secret key of this law. 61, Ain, the Jews called it, I call it 880-418, Parzival, the fool, Aleph, 1. Therefore, 61 plus 1 equals 62. But they have also the half, 31, AL, and they have not, LA, the other half, and twice 31 is 62. Therefore, Allah, or Aleph Lamed, Lamed Aleph, equals 62, which is 6 plus 2 equals 8, Cheth, 418, Parzival, fool, Aleph, 1, or none, and thus all disappears in 1. Also, since Allah becomes Aleph, all has disappeared. Again it is written, the fool hath said in his heart, there is no God. La'al, or Lamed Aleph, Aleph Lamed, or L-A-A-L, which again indicates the secret, and I think La'al in this form is the secret name or word of Rahur Kui. See chapter 3, verse 49. I am in a secret fourfold word, the blasphemy against all gods of men. Also, whereas Nuit and Hadit are ever united, the division becomes manifest in Rahur Kui, for he says in chapter 3, verse 2, there is division hither homeward, there is a word not known. Can there be a connection here with she shall be known and I never? Spelling is defunct, all is not ought. Not ought may indicate the nature of the all law, not all ought. Verse 48, note the ox or aleph and the fool or zero seems to indicate the explanation given above. Also points to the idea that the key is something which itself combines these ideas. Chapter 1, verse 51 mentions the four gates, and this is the mystery of the path of Aleph again, and the fourfold name Rahur Kui. One can enter these in turn or at once if he understands the trick of combinations. Chapter 1, verse 52, if this be not aright, if ye confound the space marks saying they are one or saying they are many, etc., there should be no space marks except on the plane of reason. When the experience of this mystery is granted, it will be seen how there are none, for the whole thing is a continuous process, even as Nuit is continuous. Chapter 1, verse 55. He has beheld some of them, I think, as is proved by this writing. Chapter 1, verse 56 indicates that there are two halves of the equation, even as there are two aspects of this word. Chapter 1, verse 57, House of God is Beth-El, Path of Beth. Chapter 2, verse 2, I, Hadit, am the complement of Nuit, my bride. This indicates that they are really one or none, and I think the word clears this up. Chapter 2, verse 7, Come unto me is a foolish word, for it is I that go. Come unto me is the call of Nuit, when Hadit, A-L or Al, considers Nuit, L-A or La, or lifts up his head, he becomes not, therefore he goes. Chapter 2, verse 14. Now let there be a veiling of this shrine, now let the light devour men and eat them up with blindness. Now let the light devour men and eat them up with blindness. Verse 15. For I am perfect being not, and my number is 9 by the fools, but with the just I am 8 and 1 in 8, which is vital, for I am none indeed. Hadit here clearly says that he is not, for being not a combination of Nuit and Hadit as the perfect and perfect, which, be it remembered, are one, nay, none, we have considered his particular aspect as A-L rather than L-A, but the previous verse indicates a blind. He is the shrine veiled by not, for A-L or all, God, is the manifestation of L-A, law, not, and law is the hiding of all. See first verse of chapters 1 and 2. He is 8 with the just because they consider the balance of things, and so consider him as Allah, which again gives 62, which reduces to 8, Cheth, 418, Fool Aleph None, as explained before in answer to that riddle of Nuit. This shows he is 1, Aleph, in 8, and also None, quite clearly. Now comes the striking indication of an underlined formula in this book, which can be read in two ways. And the very same word is used to express this, only in the English instead of the Hebrew, which of course throws one off the scent of the mystery. Chapter 2, verse 19, Is God to live in a dog? No, but the highest are of us. Now in English, God is dog if reversed, but the Hebrew for God is Aleph Lamed, which reversed gives Lamed Aleph, which is not. One can hardly get away from the hint of the true nature of the key once it is pointed out, especially since it is followed by the negative no, another translation of la or lamed aleph, and a statement that the highest or those who comprehend this mystery are of us. Chapter 2, verse 23. I am alone, there is no God where I am. I am all one, there is la all where I am. Viz. He is both one with Nuit and Rahur Kui. Chapter 2, verse 26. I am the secret serpent, wisdom of the word, coiled about to spring. If I lift up my head, I and my Nuit are one. If I droop down my head and shoot forth venom, there is rapture of the earth, and I and the earth are one. Gives another proof of the peculiar dual aspect of the word. It will be noticed that Nuit has said that the god and the adorer are upon the earth. As god, Hadit is one with the earth. As not, he is one with Nuit. Also, Hadit is called her secret center and the world, her heart and her tongue. The house, or home of Hadit, makes the spoken word possible. Verse 27. There is a great danger in reasoning over this mystery. It must be realized. Verse 32. All their words are skew-wise, viz., they do not partake of the true peculiar nature of the true word, which is equally balanced and can be read either backwards or forwards. Verse 33. Damned for a dog, the reverse of God in its wrong aspect. Verse 76. I don't make this out yet, but it seems to indicate that it will not come till later, after the prophet's time. Anyway, AL appears twice among the letters. Chapter 3, verse 2. This was commented upon before. This whole chapter appears to me to be quite a different character to the former ones. Rahur Kuit is the word as the offspring of Hadit and Nuit. Verse 35. The half of the word of Heri Raha probably indicates some mystery in this division as indicated in verse 2. I think thus far he has been La or Lamed Aleph, for in verse 35 we have him worshipped as AL or Aleph Lamed or God, unity uttermost might of breath. Verse 47. Note according to this theory the importance of the letters and their position to one another. Also the statement that one shall discover the key of it all. By the way, verse 39 makes a statement, in it is the word secret, and not only in the English. I think this may mean that the word Al, or Aleph Lamed, does not appear at all, and not only appears in the English instead of Hebrew. I think this is one of the reasons why the original in the writing of the beast must always be included with any translation into other tongues, for there are mysteries in the English that would not work out if translated. I think verse 48 terminates the AL section, and verse 49 mentions the fourfold word which I have taken to be La Al. Verse 71 may indicate AL or Al as Chakma and La or La as Bina and the solution of the mystery in Kether Hadith. Verse 74 may indicate that the splendor in his name, hidden and glorious, is the two letters AA, the silver star. Note, according to Blavatsky, Al is the sun or phallus. Friday, 11th October 1918. I spent last evening with Therion. During our conversation, he said that he thought Nuit and Hadit were best expressed as matter and motion. He also said that all things must be considered as zero or two, as if one were arrived at, there was no getting away from it. I pointed out that there must be some formula combining zero and one, or the Tree of Life could never have been conceived of and formulated. He admitted this, but said that so far he had failed to find such. When I got to bed, I could not sleep, and a number of other things connected with this mystery came to me. One was the significant fact that when Aleister Crowley first got into touch with the brothers of AA, see Vision in the Voice, I have not any books here so cannot quote, the password was, there is no God. This seems to confirm this word as the central secret of AA, who also gave out the new law. I also noticed that new, reversed, is un, or one. Likewise, with the addition of IT, Nuit is unit. Then I remembered that in Equinox 5, I think, AL is clearly defined as the ox and the goad, also as matter and motion, and I cannot see how Aleister Crowley could have missed this connection with Nuit and Hadith, since it is undoubtedly the true formula of this present conception of their nature. Then I noticed another very important thing. I was wondering why Aleph and Lamed should be chosen, or rather why Lamed, the 12th letter of the Hebrew alphabet, should follow Aleph, the first. But this is not actually the case, for Al is the first sound in the pronunciation of Aleph, the first letter of the Hebrew alphabet, as it is also of Alpha, and the addition of Pe shows the mouth as necessary to the spoken word, though in Kether it was but a silent breath through the nose. Notice Kether is called Long of Nose. Also the image is on a face seen in profile. Viz. Only one aspect of the word can be considered at a time in the reasoning mind. It is strange also how Lamed is pronounced La-Med, this showing the duality as soon as it is taken into consideration as a separate letter. Thus is Al or Aleph Lamed in very truth the first possible sound, and notice that when one pronounces it aloud, the tongue is raised and placed against the teeth, but as soon as it is reversed, La is automatically pronounced by a slightly indrawn breath. In the silent breath of the beginning, this is reversed. All is the underlying sound of the indrawn breath, and law that of the outgoing. Now notice how Hadit is spoken of as the tongue of Nuit, and how when his head is raised, etc., and lowered, etc. Note also how in producing the first letter Aleph, one's tongue must meet the teeth, and the tooth is Shin, the 31st path. Also see how these paths were welded in the initiation of OIV-VIO. Note, Layla or La-La may stand for not, or something, which also suggests 0 equals 0, or 0 to the 0 degree. All-Law suggests 1 to the 0 degree, La-All suggests 0 to the 1st degree, nothing under its three forms. I also found, which seems to be of the greatest importance, that the essence of Thelema is summed up in this word. A is the pentagram, the star of will, and L is Libra, justice or the law, while 31 backwards is 13, which is love and unity. Ruler of Libra is Venus, love. Love is the law, love under will. October 16th. Another discovery. During the initiation of December 1917, the mind of OIV-VIO must have actually reversed and run backwards, see Liber Tisharb, so that on reaching the beginning of the ideas underlying the Hebrew alphabet, he naturally arrived at the first letter Aleph in its reverse order. He came therefore to Pei, which accounts for the flash, destroying the house of God, or Bethel, then in due sequence to Law, or nothing. This again reversed, as stated, and he got Al, followed by another flash, Pei. Observe how all this summed up in one letter, Aleph, which is one and none. Further, the process as described produces the two Alephs, or A's, thus indicating the inmost meaning of AA. But now, if we begin to take into consideration two letters, we find in the return process, Ba equals to come or go, which again reverses as Ab, the father. Analyzing the complete process, we get Tau Yod Pei, Beth Lamed Aleph, Aleph Lamed Beth Yod Tau. Tau is the Tau cross mentioned by OIV-VIO as the sign accompanying the process, also the universe. Yod is the creative essence, also hand which makes sign, and this is the spark of light first seen outside. Beth is the magician who makes the sign, also the house of God, the body. Pei is the flash referred to in the destruction of all resulting in Lamed, balance, then Aleph, equilibrium, the point perfectly centered in breast, Hadit comprehended for a moment. Aleph Lamed or Al, God, Pei, another flash, the flaming sword, Beth, comprehension of this dual process in one and nothing, and understanding of Beth El as true house of God, Yod, creative essence of the word, Tau, producing a new universe. Notice how all this is borne out in the actual experience of OIV-VIO as recorded. October 19. Another discovery regarding Parzival, as already mentioned, that this word reversed was what led me to the discovery of the mystery of AL, and finally to that of Aleph in which all is summed up. I also noticed today that the three grades of the order may be summed up in the letter Beth, for Beth is the magician or the lover, Yod is the hermit, and Tau the universe or man of earth. Again, AL suggests by shape the square and compass very accurately, as used by Masons to symbolize God. Now I feel that there is no more to be said on this matter at this time. Therefore, I may return to the contemplation of this mystery in silence. Statement of the author. March 13, 1948. I, Charles Stansfeld Jones, Freighter Achide, etc., of Tall Timbers, Deep Cove, British Columbia, Canada, being the author of the accompanying manuscript entitled Liber 31, a part of my private magical diary originally transcribed and typed with one carbon copy in November 1918, the single copy having been delivered to Aleister Crowley by mail early in September 1919 and since lost or destroyed, do now make the following statement. On March 4, 1948, I received from Gerald J. York, Esquire, of 5 Montague Square, London, W1, England, a letter which contained the following. As you probably know, Aleister Crowley had died. I am sorting his papers prior to their dispatch to America. Your Liber 31 has not survived amongst these papers, though there is a reference to it on page 127 of the Equinox of the Gods. Would you care to send me a copy, which on my death will go to the British Museum with my other Crowleyana? I think it important that one copy of your Treatise 31 should exist in this country, as if it does so exist, it will be available for anyone sufficiently interested in Libraire to wish to see it. In response to this request, and for the purpose stated by Mr. York, I have had prepared from the single original manuscript in my possession one further typescript and four carbon copies. The typescript which accompanies this statement has been personally checked by me and is a true copy, only one extra note having been added on the first page in reference to the original date of the delivery of the manuscript. Of the four extra carbon copies, it is my intention to deliver one to Miss Grace R. Hollam of Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada, and one to Dr. J.P. Cowell of 5821 Shane Street, Detroit 11, Michigan, USA, so that there may be a record in these countries as well as in England. One of the remaining two copies will be attached to the original manuscript in my files, and the other kept in case of later publication or other need. Further copies are not to be made without my written permission.